Hi, my name is Felix, and today we will see how to work with Google Sheets using the R programming language. First, we will see how to connect R to Google Drive and see how to list all the existing spreadsheets we have. Then we will see how to write data that we have in R into a spreadsheet and how also to read any of these spreadsheets into R. We'll see also how to append, so add data in an existing spreadsheet, how to rename a worksheet, and also how to change the file access permission. So if you have a private file you want to share with the world or with specific email addresses, you can do it also directly from R. You can get all the code of this tutorial by joining my newsletter on felixanalytics.com. And once you subscribe to my newsletter, you will receive an automatic email from me with the URL of my GitHub account. That being said, let's get started. We are in RStudio now, so the first thing we want to do, as always, is to install and attach the necessary R packages for this project. And using the Google Drive package, we can run the drive underscore auth to authenticate to our Google Drive. This function will allow you to authenticate via your own web browser. You can accept it and then allow Google Drive to access your own private Google Sheets. Then once you're connected, you can simply run this gs4_find function to list all your existing Google Sheets. Here, as you can see, I don't have any worksheet to work with, but if you do have some in your own Google Drive account, they should appear over here. So now what we want to do for this tutorial is to take some random data and create a new Google Sheet. To do that, we will use the Texas housing dataset that is accessible in the ggplot2R package that is loaded when you load the tidyverse R package. So let's do this and call our dataset df over here. And this data contain housing sales in Texas by area and by date. To write the Google Sheet, we will use a gs4_create function over here. And what you should do is to give it a name using the name argument. Here we will call it just Texas housing. And then under the sheets argument, we will call our df object, which contains our dataset. And here, if we create a list, we can choose the name of the worksheet. So here I called it sheet one. You can give the worksheet the name that you want using this list function over here. And as you can see here in the R console, we created a new sheet called TX housing. We also saved the output of this function in a ss_texas_housing object. We see in our R console information about this spreadsheet. So it's its name, its ID, and also local on time zone, as well as information about the dataset. So here, as you see, we see the 9 variables on 8,603 rows. Using the gs4_browse function, you can also open the new Google Sheet you just created in your own web browser. So let's do this. Here is our data, but this time in Google Drive. And we have one more row because this is the name of the variable that are here in the row number one. Now let's see how to read this Google Sheet we just created into R. So the first thing we want to do is to find the worksheet. So we call this Texas housing over here. So calling the gs4_find function, we can easily find this Google Sheet. And using this meta object, we have access to the metadata. So the name, the ID, on other information about this Google Sheet. So there are three ways to read this Google Sheet. One is just to take the URL. So here with the past zero function, I just create the URL. Then you can call the read_sheet function. As you can see here in the R console, the read_sheet function indeed retrieved our data. You can also use this function using the ID only. So it's easier to use. So you don't have to get the full URL, but just the ID. And finally, maybe an even easier way to read it is to use a drive_get function to get the metadata of your Texas housing object. And we just have to call the name of your worksheet. And then you can call the read_sheet function on this. You can also use a range specification just to access specific columns or rows of your dataset. So here I call the range A1 to C6. And as you can see in the R console, I have only the three first columns and the six first rows, including the column variables over here. Now I will show you how to append and create new worksheets from R. So we will just create a multiple dataset by city. So once again, we will use a gs4 underscore create function with a new name, cities, and then the sheet will be sheet 1 with the city, with our dataset about the first city. Now what we want to do is to append or bind by rule this first city using the data from the second city. So we will reuse this metadata that we have here about our new worksheet. On this object, we will call the sheet underscore append function on our worksheet. And this time we will use the second dataset that is here, df underscore city2. And in the R console, as you can see, the package told us we just appended 187 rows on our sheet 1. So just to be sure, let's read this new worksheet we just created with the two city names. Actually, we can count by city just to be sure we have the two cities. And indeed, we have our two first cities over here. Now I want to show you how to create a new worksheet. So once again, we will take the metadata about this specific Google Sheet. And then we will use the sheet underscore add function with a new name. And we'll put it after our first worksheet that we called sheet 1. And that will create a new worksheet that is empty. On this empty worksheet, we will push the new data about the third city we extracted the data from. And it looks like it's correct. We can call the sheet underscore names function on our metadata just to be sure we indeed have two different worksheets now. And indeed, we can see it's the case. Now let's say we want to rename the worksheet name. Here we call it city3, but we want instead to be called Arlington. To do that, once again, we will get the metadata about the Google Sheet we want to work on. And this time call the sheet underscore rename function with the name of the worksheet we want to rename. On here with a new name argument, we will can give it a new name. So here it's Arlington. Once again, the R console confirmed we did the operation correctly. We can double check again using the sheet underscore name function. As you can see in the R console, the second worksheet is indeed named Arlington now. Finally, if you want to give access to everyone, because here we are only working in your own private Google Drive, you can use the drive underscore share function from the Google Drive R package with the role as reader, so people can just read but not edit. And you can also use a type here to anyone, so anyone that have the specific URL of your Google Sheet can access and see the data. And finally, we can easily remove this Google Sheet using the Google Drive function, drive underscore trash over here, to remove the Texas housing Google Sheet. And we will do the same for our cities and Google Sheets. Much more can be done with this Google Sheets 4R package, but I hope this little tutorial helped you to use the main function of this package. You can get the full script of this tutorial by joining my newsletter on felixanalytics.com, and I see you in another video. Take care. Bye-bye.